I'm not bringing the lot because I'm not there for that long, but I am going to pack for all kinds of weather because when you're camping, you never know. Even though Mafeking Rover Park usually is really cold. Yeah, I've started packing, but in the meantime, I was going to make biscuits to take to camp, but I think I'm actually going to use up this dough that school gave me because we had a lot of extra. It's, I don't remember what it's called, this biscuit dough, but you make shoe puffs and you put it over the shoe and it encases it and it's really, really nice. So I'm gonna do that. And yeah, that's it for now. For those of you who have no idea what I'm talking about when I say I'm going to Mudbash, it's a rover camp. It's like Surf Moot for those of you that saw my vlogs and I went to Anglesey. That was Surf Moot. Mudbash is similar, but it's more structured. There's more activities, like you watch the cars race. There's, it's just different and better. There's more to do and I think it's more worthwhile and I'm just really excited. So yeah. So at the moment this biscuit dough is rock hard because it's been in the fridge for a while. So while I let that cool down, I'm going to make the choux pastry, which isn't too difficult because I've made it so many times now. You know, we first made it when we made eclairs at school last year. But I don't know, I've made profiteroles because I love them and that's also choux pastry. So I think choux is very versatile, but on its own I think it tastes terrible. My mum loves it on its own. I think that's really weird. Like when I was making the profiteroles, before I had even put the chocolate custard in, she was eating the profiteroles on their own, like the choux pastry on its own. And she said it was fine like that, that I shouldn't have had to do anything else to it. And I'm like, really? It's just so bland on its own. It always needs something else. Like that's why eclairs have the chocolate on top and the cream in the middle. Because on its own, choux pastry just isn't appealing, at least not to me. But yeah, that's it for now. I keep saying that and then I keep saying something else. Clearly I have a lot to talk about. Also, I got you scouts. How snazzy are they? Because, you know, my old ones were playing up and dying. So I got new ones and they're so cool. I'm honestly such a cooking nerd. I get really excited when you weigh something up and it's exact. Oh, it is exact. So I weighed up butter and it went from 105 to 106. And I was like, oh my God, it was exact because I needed 105 grams. And it's gone back to 105. I'm like, yes, it's exact. See what I mean? I'm a nerd. I get excited about the silliest things. I was saying to my friends at Rover's house, I'm excited to go home and wash clothes. But that's because I was washing them for my bash. So, yeah, that's why I was so excited. I'm like, I'm doing it for my bash. Oh my God, I have encountered my first cooking dilemma. I don't have enough eggs. I think that I will because, oh no, I won't. I'm going to have to go get more, which is really inconvenient. Even though there is a milk bar right down the road, it's just annoying that I have to stop what I'm doing, you know? I like to be on a roll, you know, I'm doing this and I started doing it, but yeah, the recipe says you need 275 grams of eggs. I know, it's a lot. And I honestly thought we had that many. I'm close. I'm only 40 grams off, so one egg off. How annoying is that, going to the shop for one egg? But, you know, just to be on the safe side, I'm going to go get more. But I did make banana cake last week, so that's probably why we ran out. Anyway, I'm going to go do that, because I want to be on the safe side. But first I want to look around the house and see if we actually have eggs, because I don't think we do, but I think I did save one because I had extra eggs from the last time I did cooking. So, why does my scale keep turning off? That's really annoying. What an adventure. I'm finally going to the milk bar to get eggs. I'm too lazy to walk to Aldi, so I'm going to the milk bar where everything costs more, but it's a 5-minute walk, so I'm going to do that. All right, so I live across the road from a golf course and I never hear any golf being played. Soundproof walls? Maybe. Yo, you see these all the time around here? They like to swoop you, so be careful. I got the eggs. Free range eggs, that's all they had, you know. But yeah, I got the eggs. You know your eggs are good when they literally have hair on them. It's definitely come from a chicken, so that's good news. All right, so my camera's about to die, but I have everything ready. I've got this, I've got my eggs and my flour. It's not many ingredients, I know, but Yeah, everything happens really quickly with this. Like, once this is boiled, you have to add the flour, like, right away. And I could probably leave the eggs over on the bench because you just have to gradually stir them in. But yeah, I've got everything that I need, and it happens really, really fast. I mean, there's boils, and then you're like, whoa, add the flour. So yeah. All right, so my my dough is ready because I just did a bit of practice piping. Like, I piped a couple practice ones just to see if it was ready. And it is. So then what I have to do is pipe them all on. And because I don't have my circular cutters, I found these ones in the drawer. So I'm just going to improvise. And what you have to do is just cut it, put it over the top, and just don't push it down because then it won't have the desired effect. But yeah, that's essentially what you have to do. And I'll show you guys an example. And yes, I know they are kind of weird love hearts. I don't really like them. So I think I might do some stars, some love hearts, and I have flower cutters as well. So yeah, because it's going to be a bit hard to film myself, like set the camera down and film myself piping the rosette. It's with my choux pastry. I'll just show you what I mean. Like that. And then what I'll do is I'll put one of these on top. Probably should pipe my things a bit smaller or get a bigger cutter. But yeah, I want to have these a bit bigger than I normally make them, so I will get a bigger love heart. But that's essentially what you have to do. And don't push it down too much. I don't remember what the explanation was for that, but you're not supposed to push them down. Because then it's a bit hard to cut them in half. So yeah, that's it. We keep each other company. Oh, well, maybe we can't be each other's company. All company. Let's set each other's lonely nights be each other's paradise. Need a picture for my frame. Someone to share my brain. Tell me what you wanna drink. I'll tell you what I got in mind. Oh, I don't know your name, but I feel like that's gonna change. You ain't gotta be my lover for you to call me baby. Never been around no pressure. Ain't that serious? So I've piped a tray, I've got more dough, I've got a lot left in there. So I will need a second, maybe third tray, but that's what I've done for now, and I'm just going to add the rest of the love hearts on, and some stars, maybe some flowers, and keep going. So that's about all I have to do, and then just shove them in the oven, which I have not even turned on yet. My things are in the oven, and I don't know if those things are actually going to hold their shape. It looks like they're doing okay at the moment, but also I just put them in. So what you have to do is put them in 180 at 15 for 15 minutes, and then open the oven to let the steam out. But that has to after 15 minutes, or they'll just they'll die. And then you have to reduce it to 160, and then let them cook until the choux is dry, which from memory will be another few minutes. It won't be much longer. I'm just curious to see how this works out and if they actually hold their shape. I'm honestly not liking my chances. The stars look okay, but the love hearts are... I don't know, it looks like the love hearts are kind of melting over. I'm not sure. It'll be nice anyway, because the biscuit doughs are really good. Yeah, I've got to do dishes now. So yeah, and the washing is done, so I've got to put that on the line. The fun stuff. Love cooking, hate washing dishes. Okay, so they definitely didn't hold their shape. I didn't think they would. I just don't think the biscuit is designed to be a certain shape. It's just meant to fold over, which it has. It's a bit hard to see through the glass. But yeah, I'll show you when they're out. I was going to film it when I opened it, but I didn't want to let too much steam come out. But the steam did come out like it was meant to. I kind of wish that I had filmed it. It was pretty cool. But yeah. I've just put the timer for 5 minutes, and I hope that that's... alright, but it might need more, I'm not too sure. But it's looking good. I'm happy with my choux.
You gotta do the cooking by the book. You know you can't be lazy. Never use the messy recipe. Your cake will end up crazy.
Alright, so some of them turned out really well, like that one. That's how they're meant to be because it's nice and high. But a lot of them have flattened. See, again, the ones, this one here is also really good. Okay. But then, yeah, the rest of them have flattened a bit. I'm not really sure why. Like, that one is completely flat. That just has no, I don't know, firmness to it or anything. That one's alright, but yeah, I'm not really sure why it's like that. Obviously, they are too close together because the biscuit really does, like, fold over. And see, these, without it, you know, they're quite flat too, but, like, they stuck together at least. I mean, they didn't stick together, so. I don't know.
Hi again, vlog. My hair's in plaits. I got my mum to do it for me so that it's kind of curly-whirly tomorrow. I hope that it has the effect that I'm desiring. Anyway, I'm editing my video and I thought I have footage from a while ago from when I went to my master's and that I never edited. And I feel like I may as well just throw it into this video. So this video is going to be, you know, my day before my bash, just my cooking. And then I'm going to throw in my my footage from Mount Masson because it's just really nice and I want to use it. But I don't really know if there's enough of it to really make a whole video. So that is what I'm going to go do now. And, you know, I went and got my alcohol from my bash and I've just got to go and decant it. But I'm still, I've got to find water bottles or plastic bottles to put them in because you can't have glass. So that I had to do, but it's already nearly midnight here. So I'm probably going to do that tomorrow. And I'm not getting picked up till 12 in the afternoon. So there's still plenty of time. So I'm not concerned about that. Yeah, I'm going to bring a bigger suitcase in and move my clothes and everything into a bigger suitcase. Because I'd also like to have my pillows in the suitcase so that I don't have to carry them separately. And the other suitcase is just much longer and a bit deeper. Whereas the one that I've got is honestly not as big. I thought that it would be okay and that the other one would be too big, but the other one's definitely going to be much better. I just couldn't really be bothered getting it because it's so far back. But I don't care if I have to move stuff. I'd rather get that one. So I'm going to say goodnight and I'll see you guys soon in a few days when I edit my Mudbash vlogs. Bye!
Go around the roundabout, like there. Mount Masson.
Yeah.
Hello YouTube, we're here in Mount Macedon. We're here to visit these gardens I've been wanting to visit for years. Like, I haven't been in ages and we're finally here and I'm so excited.
Why did it clip?
We're all wearing whitish shoes. Crunchy, 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 crunchy. We're here, bitches.
Wait, is this the whole thing?
How beautiful and peaceful is this place? It's just so foresty, you know, and it's so quiet in this part. Like, if you go way up the steps it's really loud, but here it's just so quiet.
You should invest in a microphone, Embryo.
No, they can hear me fine. Oh, so I'm nearly dead. Jesus. Here's a vlog I take for you all. I'm not fit. That's all I've got for now. See you guys soon. Hey David.
Hey Embryo.
Having fun?
Yeah, I'm having
I'm having lots of fun. Hey Mom.
Are you having fun watching this video, subscribers? Subscribe.
Are you watching? What are you doing?
Look at my cute mom on YouTube. Look how cute she is. That's the Macedon Memorial Cross right up ahead there. There it is.
So, as predicted, I didn't get a lot of footage in my Mastin, and I remember now that that day my camera died. My camera battery died, and yeah. So that's why I didn't get that much footage. That's why I thought it would just be good to throw it into this video. And so, yeah, because it wasn't long enough to make a separate video, so I figured it'd just be good to throw it all together. That's the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and again, my next videos will be my Mudbash vlogs. And I hope that you really enjoy those ones, and they'll be up, give me a week. I'll be back on Monday, and probably get cracking on my editing then. So I'll see you guys soon. Bye!